This is a panel discussion on Civil Services Speciality Test. With me in the panel, there are 8 IAS officers of 2015 batch. For your benefit, in this discussion, we'll take up all the aspects of Civil Services Speciality Test. Now, I will invite all the members to introduce themselves.
Hello, everyone. I am Harshal Pancholi from Ujjain, Madhya Pradesh, and I am IAS 2015 batch.
Hi, I'm Prashant Pawar, IAS 2015. I'm from Delhi.
Hi, I'm Rituraj, IAS 2015. I'm from Jharkhand.
Hello, I am Basirul Haq, IAS 2015 batch, and I'm from Jammu and Kashmir.
Hello, I'm Suhash Bhagat, IAS 2015 batch. I'm from Samastipur, Bihar.
Hello, I am Savan Kumar from Bihar, and from 2015 batch IAS.
Hello, I am Sumit Sattavan, IAS 2015 batch from Jodhpur, Rajasthan.
Hi, I am Rahul Huda, IAS 2015 batch. I am from Haryana.
What exactly this interview is all about? I mean to say that the UPSC has designed this program called as Personality Test. We don't call it Civil Services Interview, we call it Civil Services Personality Test. What are the objectives of the UPSC behind this personality test? I mean to ask that what the selectors are looking for in a candidate.
Sir, the personality test of UPSC is like a grand finale of the mega event that a candidate goes through after pre and main examination.
Yeah, very nice.
This is not just an interview or a question answer session, rather a personality test in which the overall traits are tested for a candidate if he's suitable for the various top jobs which are on the offering through this examination. So the focus is on the balanced personality, the emotional understanding of the candidate, and overall awareness about the various issues that is going on in the society, country and international. As well as the focus now is more on his suitability to the job that's the most important jobs like Indian Administrative Service or Police Service or Revenue Service and various other services. So rather than just being an job interview, it's more of your test of your aptitude and attitude if you are suitable for the topmost job of the country.
UPSC has a notification regarding also what are the guidelines for civil service interview. Sure. Would you like to highlight those guidelines which is given also in the notification?
Sir, the guideline specifically says that candidate will be tested on the overall general awareness that a normal person, that a general person should possess, and his decision-making abilities, with a special focus on the weaker and marginalized sections, and empathy towards the weaker sections, and his dedication to the overall service of this thing. So rather than just being a test of your knowledge, it's more of a test of your personality and the basic etiquettes that you should have being a public servant.
What is the role of knowledge and how this personality is going to be assessed in the interview? So Basir, would you like to give some opinion on that?
So I would like to suggest one thing, that UPSC clearly defined that we are not going to test only the knowledge of a candidate. We are going to test the knowledge as well as personality or social traits of a candidate which is suitable for the civil services.
Very right.
And civil services of different type, for example, you are going to the Indian Administrative Services or Police Services or Foreign Services. So how much you are sensitive about your country, about your society, and about the welfare of the people. So it simply shows that the sensitiveness, awareness, and also the judgment, critical analysis or judgment of a particular candidate for the services towards the nation.
So to add to what my friends already said, I think overall the underlying is personality in the whole scheme of things. So even if you don't answer any factual question, it does not matter. But if they give you some situation and you are able to analyze it critically, then that makes a lot of difference. And through these questions only they test you whether you have that sort of body language and confidence, as you already pointed out. So more than that, it's how a person thinks on any particular situation rather than what he knows. If, for example, if I give you any factual question, for example, number of islands in Andaman and Nicobar, and questions of that sort, and if you're not able to answer that, it's perfectly all right. But if I give you some situation and you're not able to analyze it critically, then that's a major.
So you mean to say that if you are not knowing some factual questions answer of that.
It is perfectly all right.
So in that case, I think candidates should said very politely and nicely, yes, that sir. I don't sue, no, sir. That is a better answer for that.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
Sir, I would like to add that, the objective is of course that personality, that the how you present yourself, how you handle the pressure, etc. But a few obvious things cannot be actually neglected during the day of your personality, like what the current affairs is, like what the newspaper headlines are, etc. Obviously, the focus is generally also on the international affairs. Lots of things do keep happening and are generally discussed. So a few things should be really kept in.
So the personality test actually completes the entire 360 degree evaluation of a candidate in this examination.
Right.
The limitation of even a perfectly drafted question paper in an exam is that it cannot counter question you. If you have an opinion or if you suggest a fact, it cannot counter question you, and that too on your face, and that too impromptu. So that ability to reflect upon your answer at that very moment, jaisa Hindi bolte hain wo tol mol ke bol wali hai. So that attitude is needed in public sector working. So that is tested by this. And as far as knowledge goes, see, there is some basic knowledge that is required of everybody. As if for instance, I am an electrical engineer, and if somebody asks me what is current, define current, or what is Ohm's law, any basic, so I cannot say no to that. But if I am asked some hi-fi electrical engineering thing or some electronics thing, you are carrying a mobile phone with you, how many circuits it has,
right.
So I am not expected to answer that. But if I get on a back foot on that, saying that, oh god, what he asked me such thing and I don't know that, so that is there to evaluate for yourself, that are you ashamed of not knowing that thing.
Although UPSC interview is about your personality, but knowledge plays a very critical role. First thing I would like to point out, that it provides you a confidence which reflects, which provides a very good reflection on your personality. Secondly, the nature of knowledge itself changes. You do not focus on the minute details of the issue, but the broad ideas and the concepts through which you solve a particular problem. I would like to point out a particular question asked from me during my interview. I am a chemical engineer. So during my M.Tech thesis, I was working on carbon dioxide capture from environment. So they asked me, what is its social utility, and they did not go into the technical details, minute details of the problem, but they asked me about the social relevance of the issue. So what does it reflect is that your knowledge should be more socially oriented, and that's what one must focus on while preparing for the interview, rather than about the mugging of many things related to current affairs.
I want to add one more thing. Harshal very beautifully underlined this point, that confidence plays a very good role. What I simply said, that knowledge is simply give you a confidence. What I observe in my first interview, they simply ask me some little bit of questions of computer engineering, and even if you are not a computer engineer, you can simply answer that question. But my level of confidence was low in such a way that I can't answer that question, that easy questions at that point of time. So I practiced a lot in my in this attempt, and they simply ask me, what is Digital India? I can answer that question, but they ask me one more question, what is, do you know this rupee card, like that? So I said, I have heard about it, but I don't know what exactly it is. So it simply shows you that Digital India, because I am a computer engineer, you must know that what is Digital India. But if you don't know the rupee card, that doesn't matter to them as well as to me. So confidence plays a very good role.
लेकिन इसमें जो नॉलेज की लेकर जो रोल है कि आफ्टर ऑल बिना नॉलेज का एग्जाम तो दिया नहीं जा सकता, मीन्स नॉलेज प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल देयर, बट स्टूडेंट्स ऑलवेज हैव ए कन्फ्यूजन हाउ मच एंड व्हाट काइंड ऑफ नॉलेज रिक्वायर्ड. पर्टिकुलरली फ्रॉम सावन कुमार आई वुड लाइक टू नो, चूँकि आप हिंदी मीडियम से आपने एक अच्छा रिजल्ट दिया, आप IAS बने हैं, तो बहुत सारे हिंदी मीडियम के स्टूडेंट्स के लिए भी आप बहुत बड़े इंस्पिरेशन है, तो आप कुछ हाईलाइट करना चाहें कि नॉलेज का वास्तव में इसमें रोल क्या है.
सर जहाँ तक मेरी समझ है नॉलेज को लेकर, दरअसल ये कैंडिडेट को एक सामान्य उसको मन में ये धारणा रखनी चाहिए, हम जो है किसी प्राइवेट सेक्टर में काम करने नहीं चाह रहे हैं. जैसे अगर मार्केटिंग MBA कोई व्यक्ति ज्वाइन करता तो उसके पास मार्केटिंग एबिलिटी, फाइनेंशियल एबिलिटी होनी चाहिए, सो दैट ही कैन सेल हिज प्रोडक्ट. बट आप भारत सरकार में जा रहे हैं जहाँ पर आपको सर्विस डिलीवरी करनी है, तो यहाँ पर जो बेसिक वैल्यू है, आप डेमोक्रेटिक वैल्यू, आप लोकतांत्रिक संस्थाएं, जो आपके जो पॉलिटिकल एग्जीक्यूटिव हैं, और जब आप हायर पोस्ट पर जाते हैं जो आपके लेजिस्लेटिव एजुकेटिव हैं वहाँ आप किस प्रकार समर्पण करते हैं, और दूसरा किस प्रकार सत्यनिष्ठा के साथ और निष्पक्षता जो ऑब्जेक्टिविटी है अपने विचार को अपने पॉलिटिकल बॉस के समक्ष रखते हुए और आम जनता जिसको आप सर्विस सेवा प्रदान करते हैं उसके भावनाओं को उसके इनपुट उसके प्रॉब्लम उसके जो ग्रीवांसेज हैं उसको किस प्रकार एड्रेस करते हैं, इस हम कोर वैल्यू को जो कि हमारे प्रस्तावना में दिया गया है कि सामाजिक आर्थिक और राजनीतिक न्याय इसको कैसे हम पूरा करेंगे सो दैट भारत कैन बी डेवलप इन 2050, इस वैल्यू को हमें समझना पड़ेगा। हम कोई प्राइवेट सेक्टर जॉब प्रदान लेने नहीं जा रहे हैं, कि नॉलेज किसी भी समस्या का जब समाधान करते हैं तो उसमें नॉलेज वास्तविक रूप में सही है। जैसे आप माने कि आप जो है कोई आपदा आई है, अगर माने बिहार की समस्या है वहाँ पर आपदा ज़्यादा आती है तो वहाँ पर आपको बेसिक इनपुट होना चाहिए कि मैं किस किस प्रकार का स्टेप टेक्निकल जो स्टेप हम ले सकते हैं आपदाओं को मिटिगेट कम करने के लिए। बट हमारी एक समझ भी होनी चाहिए उस जो आप जो जम्मू कश्मीर में जो स्टेप लागू हो सकती है वो स्टेप हम बिहार में लागू नहीं कर सकते हैं। उत्तराखंड की बात और बिहार के बारे में स्थिति क्या एक अलग है, ये हमारा कॉमन सेंस पर्सपेक्टिव उस जो टेरेन है उस एरिया है उसके आधार पर हम वहाँ पर अप्लाई करें। जहाँ तक जो व्यक्तित्व परीक्षण है जो पर्सनैलिटी टेस्ट, ये ओवरऑल संपूर्ण रूप से हमारे व्यक्तित्व की उस समय उनके समक्ष प्रस्तुत करता है कि हम अब मेरे अंदर कितने विश्वास हैं, क्योंकि उस आधे घंटे में वो देखता है क्या ये बच्चा जो सामने है क्या वो सामने जो जब वो अपने फील्ड में जाएगा उस चुनौती को उस प्रकार हैंडल कर पाएगा जिस प्रकार अभी अगर थोड़ा सा इन पर प्रेशर दबाव उत्पन्न किया जाता है। तो दरअसल पूर्णतः ये विश्वास का जो व्यक्ति जैसा कि इन्होंने बसे जीवन बताया कि विश्वास होता है। सर उदाहरण के लिए जैसे मैंने अपना पहला इंटरव्यू था तो उसमें सिंपल क्वेश्चन ये था कि प्लासी का युद्ध कब हुआ, बक्सर का युद्ध कब हुआ, जबकि मैं पूरा जीवन हिस्ट्री पढ़ा था क्योंकि इतना कॉन्फिडेंस कम था मैं बोल नहीं पाया। होता है कि अगर आप शुरुआत
पहले इंटरव्यू मतलब वो भूल गया वो भी
भूल गया वो तो होता है कि सर जब आपके पास कॉन्फिडेंस रहता है ना शुरू में अगर दो क्वेश्चन बंक हो गए तो आपका जो कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल काफ़ी नीचे चले जाता है। अगर आप कुछ क्वेश्चन अगर अच्छे से लगे तो फिर आप आगे के सभी प्रश्नों को जो जो वास्तविक रूप से वो बाद में क्वेश्चन शुरू में तो परिचय केवल होता है और बाद में आपके व्यक्तित्व की परीक्षण की जाती है। इसलिए नॉलेज यहाँ पर इम्पोर्टेंट भूमिका निभाता है आपके कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल को बरकरार रखने में। तो हम लोग जैसा कि बताया बशीर जी बताया कि हमको कम से कम बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन जिस सब्जेक्ट को लेकर हम आगे बढ़ रहे हैं उसके अवश्य मूल के मूलभूत जो चीज़ें हैं हमें अवश्य पता होनी चाहिए उसके बारे में।
द कंक्लूजन कम्स दैट रेलेवेंट थिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो एन आर्ट एंड अ लॉट ऑफ अवेयरनेस इज रिक्वायर्ड कि व्हाट आर द रेलेवेंट थिंग्स in terms of facts about one candidate's self, the biorator, the surrounding, the national, international issues, and also the educational background, what the subjects he has read, what are the optional subjects. So some basic factual smartness and knowledge is must there. But in addition, and that adds to confidence when a candidate is prepared. Naturally, when the preparation goes through the pre and mains, a lot of information already there. But when you have brushed up the things at the latest level, so your confidence level goes to a next level of the preparation. But overall, what's important is how you are going to present your information, and when you are not knowing any facts, so how do you react? How do you respond? You are not losing confidence. You are not losing the track, but you are still able to maintain your patience and complete perseverance on that you are ready for the next question and go on. So I think this balance would make a candidate a good candidate for the civil service interview, right?
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.